Welcome to the Intuitive Messenger Channel. My name is Mitchell Osborn. You can find me at mitchellosborn.com to see all the different services I have to offer to you as a tarot, Lenormand card reader, animal communicator, psychic medium, and mindfulness facilitator. But this is a unique way to read for yourself. So many people often say, oh, I can never read for myself. And you know what? I get a lot of other readers coming to me to have a reading for themselves. And oftentimes it's really just confirmation. And I was thinking about this and Spirit dropped this in my head. I've tried it for myself. I like the way it worked. And what you need is a deck that you are very familiar with, that you use all the time. I'm going to be using the Legacy of the Divine Tarot. That's the one from Tito Marchetti that I use pretty much 95% of the time for all my readings. And then I'm going to be using the Rider-Waite-Smith Tarot. It's a mini one, but this one I'm somewhat familiar with. So one you use all the time, one that you're somewhat familiar with, and then one that you've never really used before or you're really, really unfamiliar with. And that would be the Chakra Wisdom Tarot. She also has Chakra Wisdom Oracle cards, but the Chakra Wisdom Tarot cards from Tori Hartman. And I did an unboxing of that one from the Chakra Wisdom Tarot, and I've probably read with it maybe two times, so I'm really unfamiliar with it. So here's what, first of all, you can choose any spread you want. I'm going to choose from Tori Hartman, Darkness, Dawn, and Light. And the first card, Darkness, is basically you don't know what you don't know. It's like it's hidden. It's like, you know, it's like there's something inside of you and you have no idea it's even there. Then the Dawn, which is like, okay, I realize something's happening, but I don't know what it is yet. And then Light is what you're privy to, what you can see, what you know you're working on and what's happening. So I chose that. Now I pre-chose the cards. I try not to think too much about them, but I pre-chose the cards because I needed to get them out. Because what I'm going to do is the first one for the Darkness, I got the Two of Wands from Chiro's deck, Legacy of the Divine Tarot. So it's like there's a choice that I'm making or I need to make, and I have no idea that it's on its way towards me. So this is coming towards me. And then the Dawn, it's like something's dawning on me, and it's like, okay, I feel like something's happening. It feels peaceful. It feels good because the Four of Swords, you know, kind of brings peace about. And it's like, but I'm still not sure what it is, but I know something's happening. I feel, you know, it's like a calm before the storm all of a sudden. And then Light, what I know is happening is the Fool card. Something's beginning. Something is starting. Something is fresh. So then you'll see those three cards, the Two of Wands, Four of Swords, and the Fool card. Then you take the deck that you're somewhat familiar with, and you pull that out. So the Two of Wands now, when I look at this, now it brings a new light to me because I see this card. It's like, okay, there's this longing. There's something underneath the surface that I don't know about, and it's a longing. So I can start to put some words to it now. And then the Dawn, what I'm starting to feel, and this shows me ultimate rest. I kept getting peace, but this could be forced rest as well. So I might be forced to rest. But I also love the beautiful picture up here. It's like, I got a nice view though. It's okay. I got a nice view. Feels good. And then finally the Fool from the Rider-Waite. Just love this. Love all the sun because very, very different images, you know, up in outer space, but this one's bright. The sun is beautiful. The zero is right there. So it feels even different. Then I go to the deck that I'm not really familiar with. And all of these are just going to add layers into reading for yourself. And I think what it's done for me is it forces me, especially on the last one that I'm about to pull, it forces me to really think about what's going on. So for the Two of Wands, for the Darkness, you know, I look at this, and again, I don't know it that well, but I love these two wands. They're floating in the air. And this woman, this feminine energy, she's really at peace, and there's so much orange. This is orange, so this is solar plexus energy. So there's something going on underneath the surface, maybe bringing about pleasure, maybe joy, some sexual energy. And then the Four of Swords, it's like I have to look at this. This is the Four of Swords, and this is green, so this is very much heart-centered. They go with the chakras, and they don't go the way you think they would go, which is beautiful what Tori did. But this one, I love the window behind, so I'm turned away from it now. So I'm not looking at a view. I'm turned away from it, turning toward the Four of Swords. And so it's like this is the Dawn, so it's like something's happening. I might be looking away from it now. So there might be a level where I've got a nice view, and the Rider-Waite, but here I've kind of turned away from the expectation of what's coming in that piece, and I just want to be left alone. And then finally, The Fool. This one, it's really gorgeous, and it's red energy. You know, so this is your base chakra, and she's just, it's like, I know something is bubbling up already. Look at the branches of the tree. They look almost like just like waves of fire coming out, but just ready to go. The roots kind of crawling up on her, which this is, you know, like tribal energy. So really, really kind of beautiful. And so just try that. You know, try pulling a deck that you know and use a lot. One that, you're kind of familiar with. You recognize the images. And then one that you don't really know at all. Go grab one maybe that turns you off. And just layer it in with the same reading. You can do a Celtic cross this way. That'd be a lot of cards. You can do any spread that you want. So enjoy. Love to hear some feedback if this works for you as it has for me. Namaste. Again, check out my site, MitchellOsborn.com. Subscribe to this video and you click the little bell and you'll get videos every time I post them. And I'm doing a lot more lately. This is my main focus is YouTube. And namaste. All right. Bye-bye.